It's freaking cold, so let's get going.
You shall subscribe to this channel, which brings hope to the people in these dark times.
Good idea, oh lord.
Of course it's a good idea!
First off, I'd just like to thank everybody for your comments on the last video and all the encouragement you guys gave. You guys are awesome. You have no idea how much I appreciate that. I've seen some of the work that's already been done for the Great Guitar Build Off, and I'm pretty confident that I'm going to get my ass kicked, but it's going to be a lot of fun. Probably fall on my face a bit. You guys will have a good laugh. So here's to us having a good time together. If any of you have some wisdom or sage advice to share on anything in this video or how I could be doing it better, especially the stuff at the end, please leave a comment below. All right, I'm going to shut up now so you guys can enjoy the process of me stumbling through trying to make a fretboard.
Sometimes I wonder why I spend the lonely night dreaming of a song, the melody haunts my reverie, and I am once again with you when our love was new, and each kiss an inspiration. Oh, but that was long ago. Now my consolation is in the stardust of a song beside a garden wall. When stars are bright, you are in my arms. The nightingale tells his fairy tale of paradise where roses grew, though I dream in vain. In my heart it will remain my stardust melody.
So I got all the fret markers routed out here, and now I just kind of want to inlay them about the simplest way possible, which is I'm doing a crushed stone inlay here. So I'm just gonna fill these up here. I went ahead and tried it once over here by myself to make sure I wasn't totally screwing it up. The verdict is still out, but I think it'll be okay. Let's go ahead and do the rest and we'll see how it turns out.
My stardust melody, the memory of love's refrain.
Okay, the type of glue I'm using here is CA glue. You could also use epoxy to do this, and the kind of stone I used was Fuchsite.
Oh, I dream in vain, in my heart it will remain my stardust melody, the memory of love.
For the S, I'm going to do a bit of a mix, so I'll pause it. So after consulting with my wife, I've decided to stick with the same color. I didn't want to color those. I don't know if you can see it, but it looks like it's compacting it together a little bit with the CA glue, so let's do another layer. Okay, I've been mixing up this epoxy now too. What I wanted to do, originally I wanted to just put the dye in there in the pocket and then fill it up with some CA glue, but since dye is not really a structural material like stone is, then I thought epoxy would be a better idea. All right, let's try this out. Put it in here, see how accurate I can be with a toothpick. I noticed from the space-based build that with the gassing off or whatever the epoxy is doing, tends to lose a little bit of volume, so maybe just the drying out. I'm sure it doesn't have water in it, but whatever is happening, it seems to be losing a little bit of volume as it dries, and so it drops down a little bit. So what I've done here is make sure that it's sticking out a little. It's not a big deal since I'm gonna sand away a whole lot of the fretboard there anyway, but just, you know, for thoroughness sake, I'm gonna go ahead and fill it up so that it is above the fretboard right now. Up with the line, parallel to the line, but I'm leaving a little tiny gap between the wood here and the line, because the line has a thickness of about 0.3 and the saw blade has a thickness of about 0.5, so I'm trying to put 0.1 millimeter gap on the left side so that I end up with 0.1 millimeter on the other side. And therefore, I'm centering it dead center on the line. Important thing in any guitar build, the center line. Now I just need to figure out where the center of this is, mark it up, and fix it to the front board, figure out how I can center it here. And we're ready to glue it. Measure this base of the neck fretboard here at 55.3, which divided by 2 is 27.65. If my calculation is correct. Also important to wrap it around on both sides here, so you can find it later. So as you can see here, I cut away all the tape here to reveal the carbon fiber rods there, so I can get some glue on them, but not on the truss rod. And yeah, then I went and I got the glue, and so I was all ready, and then I remembered I forgot to put the truss rod in. So it's a good thing I didn't glue it. Yeah, now I get to insert the truss rod and probably redo all the taping. We'll see. Let's glue it up. Treble side. And these ones turned out just fine here. These ones were missing a couple at the base, so I added a little bit of material and glued them back up. And yeah, that's what it looks like after I shaved it all down. As you can see, that was all that's left over of the maple. Bass side, I still need to add the side dots in this area, and here's what the inlays look like from the side. I drew a line on both sides where I'm gonna shave the fretboard down to. What I'm doing, I'm trying to line it up with the sides of the fretboard so that I get a compound radius as opposed to just using a sanding block, which I have. This way I'll get something like a 16 inch radius here and a 12 inch radius down here. Maybe a little less, I don't know. I've got different gauges to help me check. And yeah, I'll just start working it down. So after many moons, I finished sanding, and this is the result. And back here, wait, what? That's the same one, 12 inch? Yeah, what happened there to the compound radius that I was planning on? Well, I'll tell you, I concentrated too long on the sides here and ended up taking away too much material on the sides. I actually brought it down to the line that I wanted to hit, but... And that's what it looks like. As you can see, there's some
mistakes. I'm kind of happy with the way these white ones are. I'm not super stoked on it. They could be a little cooler if they had some metal inlaid next to it or something. This one's got a little wiggle in it, kind of pisses me off there. This one over here is a bit squirrely too. So yeah, I'm not too stoked with my workmanship here, but whatever, moving on. So I think that about wraps it up for the fretboard for now. I'm still gonna chamfer the fret slots here and check the depth again. And I need to install the frets and do all the frets and blah blah and, you know, shape the neck and everything like that. I'll go ahead and do that in the next video, along with maybe even doing the glue up of the body parts. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.